Facebook is again at the middle of the highlight when it comes to privacy concerns after the last WhatsApp privacy update. Most of the people in the world is concerned about what's happening at WhatsApp, how these new policy changes are going to affect their privacy, what kind of data is going to be collected, and what kind of data that's going to be shared with the other parties as Instagram and Facebook. So let's talk about that. One of the biggest promises from the early WhatsApp founders was that they are not going to use WhatsApp data for monetization. And that is one reason that most of the people start using WhatsApp in the first place. But after Facebook buying WhatsApp, they were actually thinking about different ways of like how to use WhatsApp data. I think this step is not something that's so surprising because Facebook is actually relying and based on the advertising revenue. So naturally they want to take data from WhatsApp is something expected down in the line. So from user's point of view, what they're really concerned about is like, can WhatsApp access their messages? Can WhatsApp access their media? So when you're looking at the privacy policy of WhatsApp, like you see on the screen, you could see they are collecting multiple variants of data from your WhatsApp account. So they have two parts. One policy is related to the individual accounts, and the other policy is like how WhatsApp is collecting data when you're interacting with the WhatsApp business account. So let's focus on both those two aspects. The first and most common question people has is that once this data is collected, are they going to be shared with the Facebook? And the answer is yes. Most of the data that is collected under the new privacy policy will be shared with the Facebook for the purposes such as advertising. However, this doesn't mean that your messages or the content of the messages and the media are going to be shared with the Facebook. Your messages and whatever the conversations that you are having with the individuals will be encrypted as it has always been during the last couple of years. And the Facebook claims that they do not have access to the messages or the media that you are sending. So in a nutshell, while Facebook is collecting some other data such as your status updates, your device model, your GPS location, they do not have access or they will not use the content of your messages for the advertising purposes as at now. The other question is that, is Facebook storing our messages? And the answer is no. Facebook is currently not going to store your messages, and the Facebook has claimed that once a message is sent, it will be removed from their servers as soon as possible. And the only reason that the message could get saved in a Facebook or any other server is at the point that the message cannot be delivered right at the moment to the other recipient. So unless that's the situation, in the most of the normal scenarios, Facebook is not going to store any of the messages that you are sending via WhatsApp. The next question is regarding the Facebook business account. So what is going to happen really when you interact with the business account? So it's a bit of a gray area right now. The Facebook has stated that the data will be shared with several people when you are communicating with the business account. And also there are instances that if you are using the payment mechanism via WhatsApp, which is not available in Sri Lanka as yet, but is available in some other countries, those kind of payment details also can be collected at the Facebook level also. So I think when it comes to the business account, the situation is a little bit more complex than the individual account. But it's good to remember that there's a possibility that your data could be shared among multiple stakeholders when you are communicating with WhatsApp business account. The last concern is, can I stay without accepting these terms? The short answer is no, you have to accept this term. In a situation that you don't accept the terms, what will happen is that after February 8th, you will not be able to use the WhatsApp services or any other related services used to WhatsApp. This actually forces the user into a corner that if you are keen to keep using WhatsApp to keep your day-to-day life communication going ahead, you will have to agree to these terms and conditions. At EU or the European Union, you actually have an opt-out option because of the GDPR policies they have in place. But for the rest of the world, for us, we actually don't have that luxury at the moment. As a final thought, what we see is like most of the people were looking for like alternative solutions for WhatsApp also. This was inspired by a recent tweet from Elon Musk telling about how people should switch to the Signal app instead of using WhatsApp. So if you're looking for different options and solution, I think most of the people are going toward Telegram as well as the Signal options as alternative apps. So both the apps has pros and cons. Telegram has been in the market for quite a while and there's quite a bit of a user base. So if you want to look for an alternative solution, I think it's better you read and understand about the Telegram or about the Signal app might be an alternative use for you instead of WhatsApp if you're really concerned about privacy at this moment.